This video is going to show you a few more coding techniques that might be useful for your project. I'm going to first of all start by opening Ken's interview. The reason for this is I want to work with something in an audio-visual format. Here, I've got the option to click play and pause to listen back to Ken's interview.
What are your favourite places?
Down east. That's Iran, of course.
Here I can see Ken really clearly talks about Down East as one of his favourite places. So, I'm going to highlight this particular phrase of him talking about this, right click, and I'm going to code this selection, and then I'm going to choose the Sense of Community Down East code and code it there. Next up, I'm going to open one of the images in this project. I'm going to go to Area and Township, and in here, open up the competing water uses image. Here we can see the tension between boats for tourism, those recreational fishing boats, and those commercial fishing boats. I'm going to highlight this area of the image, right click, and then choose to code this selection at the economy code. And then I'm going to right click and also choose to code this selection to infrastructure. These two examples are really helpful for anyone who's working with either audio, video, or images as part of their research. It's also important to note there are some source types where you may need to switch between highlighting text and areas. This PDF is a great example. At some times I want to keep my highlighting to text so I can highlight and code the text just as I would any other source. Then there are times, such as this image, where I may want to switch to region highlighting so I can highlight this diagram and then code just like any other image. You'll only see this on certain source types. There's one other technique that might be useful for anyone working with text. I'm going to go back to Barbara's interview to demonstrate this. You'll notice that whenever you're highlighting text, I'm going to just highlight Beaufort, and right click, you have the option to code NVivo. Code NVivo will create a new code, naming it after exactly what you've highlighted. So if I now open my codes folder, I can see there's a new Beaufort code, and it has coded this particular textual reference into here. This can be really useful for anyone using a grounded approach to really ensure they're representing their codes using the text and phrases from their participants. The very final thing I wanted to show you is the code panel. You'll see the code panel is not dissimilar to that of codes in list view. However, you'll notice with your code panel open, you can then be free to navigate to the rest of your project. So here I can see all of my source files while still having access to the coding panel. This means I can highlight, drag, and drop coding just as I would in list view, without it affecting the navigation of my main project. We can also do this to code to cases using the folders down here. You'll also notice at the very bottom of my screen, there's the coding bar. You can use this to code as well. These represent the last two ways you can code in NVivo, so there's lots of flexibility and you're free to use your preference.